It's a lovely day here at Trent Bridge. The sun's out. The wicket looks a bit slow, but it looks like it's quite dry, so it'd be a good batting wicket. And India won the toss, so it was always going to be difficult for England to start with. But they got off to a good start, got an early wicket, but then Pujara and Vijay sort of got stuck into lunch. The fortunate thing was the guys came out after lunch, got a couple of quick wickets, as you do sometimes in Test cricket, you know. Even if the wicket's flat, if you get one, you can get two, which they did. And now, of course, things are settling down a bit and the ball's getting a bit older, and India are making England work hard again. But the boys have stuck at it, you know, it's not sort of racing away from the captain. I would say good bit of captaincy from Cookie. He got that sort of a short, straightish mid-on into Pujara, who managed to chip one, and Belly made a good catch. So it's nice to see something going a little bit right for Cookie at the moment as captain.
And with a pitch that isn't offering too much for the bowlers, what do England's pacemen have to do to maybe create those extra inroads and wickets, not only today but possibly tomorrow as well?
Well, sadly, the only way you can do it is by trying to build up pressure, you know, stop the flow of runs, and bowling in pairs as bowlers, and, you know, bowl one maiden, then the other guy at the other end bowls another, and so you build up the pressure by stopping the flow of runs. So that's really the only thing they can do, apart from perhaps one of the Indians playing a poor shot and getting out. And of course, obviously, the England boys perhaps bowling a good ball and getting them out with it. But if you're sort of looking at what's going to happen in the next sort of hour or so, then I think it's going to be India being careful, trying to rebuild after losing two cricket wickets after lunch, and going into tea. I suspect the honours will be quite even, with India having won the toss and India being sort of three down for, you know, somewhere around about 150, 160.
And just looking at the series as a whole, what is your gut feeling in terms of how it will play out? England had a difficult time against Sri Lanka, but played some excellent cricket and were perhaps unlucky not to get more rewards from that series.
Yeah, look, I think a fair result would have been a draw. There's some great cricket, and you know, the Sri Lankans played really well. Their captain Angelo Matthews sort of led from the front, and with guys like Sangakkara and Jai Wardner, you know, you expected a stern test, and that's what England got. So, and sadly, we managed to not last as Sri Lankan did on the last day of the last over at Lord's in the first Test match. So that was quite sad. But, you know, this series is going to be a good series. It's a five-match series, which makes it even more of a contest. Two Test matches, you know, it is a bit difficult, but five Test matches, it's going to be a real contest. It gives the side a chance to come back if they fall behind, but I think it's going to be a very even contest. I hope that the young guys who've done well so far in the two Test matches against Sri Lanka will continue to press forward, and if they can continue to do that, that will take a lot of pressure off Cookie, and hopefully he will certainly get his form back in this five Test match series and continue to lead England, because he is a solid chap, and he's one of those guys who's got the support of the players too, and there's been some obviously adverse criticism of him, so it'd be nice to see him get his name back on the run sheet.
Just a last quick question about your own personal memories of India. You had a good record against them, scored several hundreds. It's one of the marquee series, isn't it, when India come here and England have the chance to play them?
Yeah, look, India are very passionate about their cricket. They've got a lot of people in their country and they love cricket, and they really do, you know, it's one of those things that they all want to be a professional cricketer or play for India. And they've had some wonderful players over the years and continue to produce lots of talented cricketers, wonderful players. So, you know, for me, India is always a great place to tour, because you learn a lot about yourself, you learn a lot about the passion for the game and what it means to be an Indian test player over there. And it means, you know, you're playing different bowlers on different pitches, and then when you get India here, they're still competitive because they've got some wonderful batters, and you know, it is a great series to play in, and it's good to see us playing five Test matches against India, and I hope that continues for a long time.